Sweet. Cool. So we're on the call here with Cheryl. Cheryl joined the program 3 months ago. And if I get this right, Cheryl, you were in doing game design when it comes to 3D. And then after that, you were doing interior work. And then after you switched jobs, you got into doing products. And that's why you pretty much joined our product animation program. Is that right?
Yeah, that's right.
Cool. So you can just start by letting everyone know kind of what you were doing before you joined. Were you like working in a job? Were you working in a studio? Were you doing freelancing? What were you doing?
I've always been in a job, no freelance yet. So I started with game art, doing low poly models, a lot of hand texturing, stylized texture. And then I switched to interior, exhibition, those kind, using SketchUp. So
Interesting.
less texturing now because there's so many texture out there.
Okay.
And then I switched job and they asked me to do more product stuff. So I
Okay.
went to that road, more product.
And were you working in like a team, or were you kind of doing all the products on your own? How did that work?
We have a team. So the concept and animation guide was by the art director, and I just render the things out for them.
Okay. And when you joined that company, could you do any product animation yourself, or?
No, I did not do any animation. They were guiding me, so I
Okay.
was like following blindly.
Yeah.
But
Okay.
yeah.
So that's when
Mostly I do stills, yeah, still images.
still images. Okay. So when you joined, when you heard about our program and you joined, you didn't really know much about like how to do products or animation or anything like that.
Nothing much about animation.
Sweet. And where are you based? Are you which country are you staying in?
I'm currently in Singapore.
Oh, interesting. Cool. So what were things like before you joined our program? So you say you didn't really know animation, you didn't really know products, you're just kind of doing game design and interiors and stuff like that. That correct?
Yeah, that's correct.
Cool. And yeah, so then how did you end up finding out about our program?
Well, when I was doing modeling for one of the product in my company, I watched a lot of your videos and I started following you since then, like last year, I think, last December. So I follow you since, and there was so much updates, so much progress with my product shots. And when you message me, email me, I just joined it because I think I can improve more and contribute more to the company.
Interesting. Okay, there was like no hesitation with joining or anything like that.
No, it's somewhere I want to improve, like an area I want to improve on. Being able to do animation on my own instead of someone guiding me.
Okay, that's funny. Yeah, that's cool to hear because I actually sent out emails to like over 1,000 people, and I think maybe around 5 to 10 people ended up actually joining. And the interesting thing, seeing kind of people that end up getting successful at stuff, is people that just make quick decisions and like actually invest in themselves, and they don't really delay or have to think about things because a 1,000 people is a lot of people, but only like 5 or 10 ended up actually taking action. So it's cool to hear that because I've emailed a lot of people, and a lot of people will be like, "Oh, I need to think about it, or I need to wait." And yeah, it's just interesting. I'm sure this will be kind of like a theme around the way you kind of went about learning and stuff. You didn't really like wait around; you just kind of went for it, which is cool.
Yeah, I've been learning a lot of YouTube videos. There was so many things I wanted to learn during the COVID period, right? Because everyone's just at home. Yeah, so just spamming YouTube videos, learning tutorials, but there wasn't any clear road for me to go.
So you're
was
kind of
looking
looking
at
for
VFX, yeah.
like a roadmap or direction to go into.
Yes, I mean, after I write everything down, I decided like maybe I should take things one at a time and go for your course. After I finish that, I'll see where I'll go next.
That's cool. Cool. And what were things like after you joined?
Great, I feel better. I don't
Like,
really rely on that anymore.
so when you joined, was it like overwhelming? Like, what were your thoughts after you joined? Do you think so let's just start from like where would you say you were? Were you like a beginner or like intermediate or advanced?
A little bit over the beginner because I know some camera movements using the spline tool, but don't really know how to utilize them fully. So after watching all your videos, yeah, I know how to use most of the things now.
Okay. So it, after you joined, you're like around the begin the, around the intermediate stage.
Around there, yeah.
Cool. Yeah, I'm just asking so I can get so like all the viewers and stuff that are listening to this can kind of get an idea of like where you were at when you joined and kind of see your progress from there. So yeah, once you joined, like how were things? Were the videos like a bit overwhelming? Was it a bit difficult? Or was it just like a easy breeze for you?
It was a very good pace. I focused mainly on the post-processing, animation, and what is it? There's eight modules, right?
And the
Hold
lighting?
on. Lighting, yeah, lighting is quite big. After lighting, I went on to focus on the animation and rendering. And pre-production is super important. I like that one.
Interesting. Cool. Yeah, that's awesome to see. So you kind of needed like a few areas to brush up on, and yeah, it's cool. So how much time did you actually end up putting in? Like, let's just say on average, how much time did you end up putting a day, let's say watching a video? How much time did you spend practicing?
So I watch the video first. I watch all of it and then I start practicing. And then whenever I forget things, I'll just go back to the video and watch it again. And worked, yeah. I do it after my work hours, so let's say about three hours a day.
3 hours a
Then during
day.
the weekend I'll just yeah, during the weekend I'll just do as much as I can.
That's cool. So you already had a job, but then you still found time like 3 hours a day after that to put into like improving your 3D.
Yes.
Wow, that's impressive. Cool. Yeah, it's very interesting. Like, also why I'm asking these questions is for myself because the people there are people that join the program and people that kind of just don't do anything. You ask them questions like, hey, how's things going? You never hear from them. And it's interesting with you. I think you're the first person that watched everything and you also went through it the fastest, which is also, I think, why you saw the most improvements, which is pretty cool. Yeah, it's pretty awesome stuff to hear so far. And yeah, so how long until you started to see improvements after you're like practicing consistently for like 3 months?
I was actually quite scared to go in the animation part. So I practiced on my lighting. And then I look at your Coke commercial. I'm like, okay, that's quite simple. There's the camera movement, just simple things. I'll just try that out. And the results was quite good. So I had a bit more confidence to try more animation stuff. So I just kept going from there.
Yeah, because I think through the whole process, I think you made like three or four commercials, didn't you? That's a lot.
About three, yeah.
Yeah. That's a lot.
My
Cool.
goal was like to make one video a month because I think it takes about 2 weeks to finish a video, given my work hours and how much time I put on.
Yeah, you reached
Yeah.
that goal. That's cool. And So this is a it's going to be difficult for you to answer, but I'm curious why do you think that you kind of improved a lot faster than everyone else did?
Not sure. I just kept doing. So you gotta start small to, give yourself more confidence to continue to continue more things. It's like I don't know. I just imagine I can do it, and I watch a lot of commercials on YouTube to see how they move their objects and camera. So I replicate it and put it on my videos.
That's awesome. That's actually how I like learned a lot is I would watch a lot of other people's commercials and then you just kind of steal ideas from that. And then you just apply it to your own work, and then people are like, "Oh my God, that's so creative and original!" When you kind of just stole it from other people. But what works works, you know.
Yeah.
Yeah, that's cool, and it's also cool to see because you said you found like the animation side a bit intimidating, but you still actually try like a small amount at least, because a lot of people find certain areas intimidating and they just don't even try, you know. That's cool. Yeah. So.
You gotta start small. So the Cannes commercial was a really good start to get you started in touching those product animation.
Well, that's interesting. It's good feedback for me as well. Cool. And yeah, so how's things after you've kind of gone through the whole process? Like, how are you feeling now with your animation and commercial creation and all that stuff?
Confident, but if they ask me to do simulation and dynamics part, no, that one I'm still a
Yeah,
bit scared. I don't know how to do that.
don't really go through that in the in our program, like the simulations and all that stuff. So it makes sense. Yeah, that's cool. Do you feel like you have everything that you need now to create commercials, or at least the essential stuff, excluding like all of the effects and all
Yeah, the essentials are all there.
that?
Even the post production, you even taught us how to use After Effects a little bit, but there's nothing much to go in After Effects, just a little bit of color grading, contrast, that's it.
Yeah, I'm sure it must have shocked you how simple it can be to create commercials, because a lot of people think like you need to know all this like visual effects and all these effects to do to create commercials. But a lot of it's quite basic in terms of like the post-production and the animation. You can create like really good stuff really simply, you know. It doesn't have to be too complicated. Cool. Sweet. So yeah, now that you've gone through the whole program, you say you're feeling a little bit more confident with creating commercials. Has it like affected your work in any way so far?
For work, yeah, I think it did affect a little bit. I know how to use After Effects more. So when they give me stuff, I understand how the composition works in there. The
Okay.
comp, not the competition.
So you're a little bit more confident with your job now instead of feeling how you're feeling before. That's cool. And yeah, where do you kind of see yourself, let's say 3 months from now, 6 months from now, like where do you kind of want to go with your 3D?
I'm still going to continue my goal, one video a month at least. Okay, yeah. Just a quick, small things.
So you just want to keep improving. That's cool.
Yeah, I'll just keep improving. Keep updating my portfolio. So
Yeah,
during that
cool. When
3 months,
Yeah, sorry, did I cut you off?
No, it's okay.
Yeah, it was awesome to see like your most recent 3D video. I think that's when I was like, cool, she's got everything that she needs. Like our work is done. Because after looking at that, that's like pretty much I think all you need in order to like create like commercials and stuff for companies, you don't need more than that. Obviously, things can get better. You can add in cooler music and edit things more differently, but like that's all the essential stuff that you need in order to like create awesome work. So that's when I was like super excited because essentially you quote unquote like graduated with which is cool. But yeah, what advice would you give to other people who, let's say, are trying to improve their 3D and stuff like that?
You have to start small and make sure you can nail that small part down.
Hmm.
So then you can have a confidence to keep going on.
Okay. And do you think, let's say, the community and the feedback helped?
It did. Yeah, it boosted some confidence. Like, wow, people like the work. So
yeah. Yeah, it's interesting. That's cool. Because, like, there's so many things that you need. Like, you need to do things little by little. You also need to keep consistent, which is, I think, one of the big things you've done. Like, there's been a few people that have kind of joined and then they just fall off and you don't hear about them or hear from them. But then you also kind of need like a community, like, as you see, it gives you more confidence when you see that you're doing well, and then also the feedback so that you keep improving, which is pretty cool. But yeah, that's pretty much all I wanted to chat about. I just kind of wanted to get an idea of where you were before, as well as for other people, so that they can kind of see like, hey, you can actually make a lot of progress in three months. 3 months, that's kind of short period of time, as opposed to like a lot of people spend like years just not really going anywhere, seeing where you were before. So you're kind of working in a job, what things were like once you joined our programs and stuff, how you improved, and pretty much where you're at now. And that's pretty much it. But yeah, I think we're done. So where can other people find your work if someone wants to get in contact with you?
Oh, you can find me on Behance. I recently just joined that.
Mm-hmm.
Or what's Instagram.
What's your name on Behance?
Instagram. Let me check.
Because a lot of people contact me, but I'm not really doing freelance work anymore. So I think you're the next best person to go to at the moment.
Thank you. So my Behance is at Sheffie 29. Cheffie 29.
Cool. Sounds good. Yeah. Well, thanks for jumping on the call. Excited to see how things kind of go with you for the next 3 months as well. Yeah, you're our first success story and you've made a lot of progress. So well done.
Thank you.
Cool. Yeah.